Maxwell instigated it.
I know it seems out of character, but apparently Connor's pushed at a breaking point.
I found Egbert. She's all right, but her outfit's a mess.
I'm not surprised. Miss Ferguson's just told me Williams and Maxwell roughed her up just to get back at Connor's.
Well, that explains that scuffle in the corridor.
Well, thank heavens it was just a scuffle.
The wedding will have to be cancelled, of course.
What on earth for?
We can hardly punish Egbert for something she didn't do.
Governor, you seem to be missing the point. The department only gave permission on the grounds that there was no trouble.
The trouble has been taken care of, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, well, I might be preempting a little, but naturally I have let the minister know. In fact, he's on his way here now to put a stop to, how did he put it, these stupid wedding shenanigans.
Don't worry, kid killer. They'll all be after you now, trying to stuff up Chook's wedding.
Shut up, right, Jenkins.
Kid killer.
Hey, I'm talking to you.
I reckon she's so scared she can't talk, Rick. Probably gibbering in the corner.
You okay, Kurt?
Never felt better.
You finally bit off a bit more than you could chew, Maxwell. It's going to be fun making you spit it out.
Don't kid yourself, Connors. You've had it and you know it. I mean it. I've got one thing you haven't that'll guarantee you end up on the dung heap. Brains.
You're right, Lurch. She's finally blown a gasket.
Yeah, don't sit down, Maxwell. You'll squash him.
We've still got Looney. She'll mash it a mincemeat when she gets out. Oh, that big pussycat won't try anything. And Maxwell won't make her. Gone soft on her, right, kid killer?
I don't need her, Connors. Brains will win over brawn any time.
Yeah. Well, if you've got no muscle, you get your brains beaten to a pulp. And I'm not used to anyone then.
Well, I don't know. Her and Mel would get on real well if that happened.
Yeah!
You'll be laughing on the other side of your face.
How long it takes. I'll wipe my feet on you, I swear it.
You've tried it once too often, and I promise you when I finish talking to Dwyer, you're going to wish you'd never left Queensland.
It's a little over the top, don't you think?
No, I wouldn't be so smug if I were you, Joan. Department heads don't look favourably on petty power seekers.
No, they appreciate diligent officers, though. Not ones who continually throw departmental rules out the window.
How dare you insinuate that we're not...
I don't have to insinuate, Governor. The minister is well aware of the slipshod tactics in this place. And that is why he appointed me as deputy governor. I'm not about to jeopardise his trust in me by kowtowing to a bunch of criminals.
That does it. Get Egbert and get her to the rec room now. This might be the last thing I ever do in Wentworth, but this time your tactics are not going to spoil something positive for those women.
Oh, you're too late, the minister.
I hope you enjoyed it, Miss Ferguson, because that's the last time you countermand my orders. Pity you didn't get away with it.
You go and get the dress and put her into it quickly.
But I haven't finished
the makeup. Don't argue. Just do it.
Something's happened.
Oh, sorry, Lexi. Quickly, get her into that dress as quick as you can down to the rec room.
Well, what's going on?
Oh, I don't know. Something's up. They want us straight there.
Did you fix it?
Don't fuss. You're going to look like a princess. Now you finish your eyes, okay? And I'll pop a dress on. And while I'm doing it up, you can do a lippy, okay?
Yeah, I would if she keeps still.
There. Right. Okay. Now here's the dress. Oh, it's beautiful. All we need is some flowers.
Chucky, you have smudged your lipstick.
Lexi, you're not even dressed yet.
Well, she hasn't got time to change now.
I would have if you keep your lips still. Not that still.
I'm sorry, Steve. It really is a now or never situation. If Dwyer stops it, you'll have Buckley's of getting permission when she gets to Barnhurst.
Oh, it's fine by me. How's Julie, though?
Mrs. Morris has gone to hurry them up.
Stephen, think, dear. This could get Mrs. Reynolds into dreadful trouble.
Oh, I never thought...
Now, don't you worry about that. The department approved the wedding, and I've had no orders to the contrary.
Julie should be ready in a minute. I just rang reception. The Reverend Park still hasn't arrived.
He was supposed to be here at 9:30.
I know, but we'll just have to cross our fingers and hope he hasn't been held up along the way.
Do you think that's the minister, Roger?
Looks like it.
Oh, thank heaven.
What's the rush? Morning. Mrs.
Quickly.
What's up?
No time.
Come on, what is going on?
Hey, what are you doing? Oh, there we are.
I want to sit in the middle.
No way, love. I'm going first.
Yeah. Your seat's back there, dearie.
Oh, but I can't see good.
Well, time. Yeah. Find another seat because I'm not moving, all right? Oh,
quiet, please, ladies. You have to get up here soon.
Come on, Jones. Hey, get back there. Go on. word, please, Governor.
What is it?
Despite your views to the contrary, I don't want to see you doing something that's going to land you in serious trouble.
Oh?
There's still time to call this off.
Thanks for your concern, though. I suspect it so that you can truthfully tell Dwyer you tried to dissuade me, right? Anyway, you're too late. Here's a little...
Look, adorable, absolutely beautiful.
She looks ridiculous, but then this whole thing's a farce anyway.
Well, don't worry about her. She's just in a bad mood.
Yeah, problems?
Oh, Miss Ferguson's just having one of her bad days.
She reckons I look ridiculous.
Nonsense, you look lovely.
You're the belle of the ball, eh, Laurie?
You certainly are.
Here, let me fix this
quickly,
for you.
Quickly, quickly. Everything's ready.
Oh, it's all so rushed. I do look ridiculous.
Oh, Chucky, would you cut it out?
You're marrying the man you love. That's what's important.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Julie, you really do look beautiful. I wish I had a mirror so I could prove it to you.
Yeah, you're worrying about nothing, you mad bugger.
Honest?
Would I lie? Yeah.
Oh. Right, this is it.
Oh, I think I want to be sick.
She's ready.
Club mosquito, man. Come on.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony.
Amen.
Well, let me know as soon as he arrives.
He has instructed those who enter into this union to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other through life's trials, to provide for each other temporal things, to pray for, to encourage each other in that which pertains to God, and live together as the heirs of the grace of life. If there be anyone present who can give just reason...
Forget that bit, love.
Oh, shut up and let him get on with it.
They're all for it.
Ferguson. Good.
Do you, Stephen Marcus Ryan, take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live with her, to cherish her according to God's ordinance in the holy bond of matrimony?
I will.
To live with him, to cherish him according to God's ordinance in the holy bond of matrimony?
Yeah. I will.
Place the ring on the third finger of the left hand. I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Rubbish. You totally disregarded my instructions. Now you have the effrontery to sit there and argue with me.
The situation wasn't as black and white as that.
You certainly acted as if it were.
The women involve a question and I acted as I saw fit.
It's your fitness that's being questioned here now. And believe you me, it has become very suspect.
Oh, I'm sorry, Minister. I didn't realise you were still here. Governor, could I possibly...
We'll be finished shortly. I'll look after it then.
No, come in, Miss Ferguson. On the contrary, we have a great deal to clear up here first. Frankly, if it weren't for Miss Ferguson, I wouldn't have a clue about what is happening here.
I'm sure she's quite capable of relaying her version of events.
I hope I don't have to defend myself for carrying out instructions.
Not at all. Your report was quite in order.
Egbert did nothing to warrant cancelling her wedding.
Sir, the women have been at each other's throats lately. Anyone could see that this wedding was just an excuse to stir up more trouble.
I'm in the habit of punishing culprits, not victims.
Fine words. But it's obvious Miss Ferguson had a better grasp of the situation than you did.
Oh, I'm quite sure Mrs. Reynolds thought she was doing the right thing. Obviously, she rushed the wedding through in order to save any backlash against the department.
Personally, I don't think Mrs. Reynolds was considering the department's interest at all.
As governor of this prison, I have discretionary powers.
It's clear to me that you've lost sight of what the department expects of you. I'll expect your letter of resignation on my desk this afternoon. In the meantime, I'd like you to take over the governorship as of now. Will you accept the commission?
Oh, yes, of course, sir. If that's what the department wants.